Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. If you didn't get the hint from our video clip, it would be greatly appreciated if you silence your cell phones for today's presentation. My name is Diana Klink, and on behalf of the City of Suffolk and the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the 2015 State of the City. I would like to ask that everyone please stand for the presentation of colors by the Suffolk Public Safety Honor Guard, and remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance led by Chief Cedric Scott, Suffolk Fire and Rescue.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. Thank you very much, Chief Scott. I would now like to welcome to the podium at this time, Susan Davis, Suffolk Division Chair of the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce. Susan?
Thank you, Diana. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, members of the Honor Guard and Chief Scott, for opening our 2015 Suffolk State of the City Luncheon. My name is Susan Davis, and it's my pleasure as the 2015 Chair of the Suffolk Division of the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce to welcome you to the final program of our State of the City series. The Chamber has again seen outstanding attendance and fabulous presentations from our region's mayors this year, and we are sure that Suffolk will not disappoint. The Commonwealth's largest and fastest growing city has so much to offer that we're not surprised that this luncheon was sold out 3 weeks ago. I agree. Now, I would be remiss today, before we start the program, to not make a pitch for the great job the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce is doing for our businesses, large or small. Whether it's looking out for our business interests with the General Assembly or Congress, providing professional networking opportunities morning, noon, and night in the region, or providing the first-rate business education programs, the Chamber is engaged in the challenges and opportunities facing us all. I strongly encourage you to attend our monthly membership meetings in Suffolk or communicate to us via email, social media, or phone, and let us know how we can help. We hope to see you all at the upcoming Mingle events this year. The first is on June 4th, just across the street at the Pavilion Visitor Center. And the second is on September 10th at the Town Bank University Pavilion located in Harborview. Please join us for these fun networking events to promote your business or services. Also, the Chamber will be tweeting today from this event, and you may follow us on Twitter at Chamber757. And if you're tweeting, please use #SuffolkSOC. Now it's my pleasure to introduce Brian Stevens, the President and CEO of Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce, to make some introductions.
Thank you, Susan. Hey, how good is this? Suffolk, Virginia. Give yourself a round of applause. Wow. Linda, I look forward to this event every year. It's fantastic. It's great to be in Suffolk as always, and it's a pleasure for the Chamber to be involved in this great event. As Susan said, as a service to our citizens and the business community, The Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce hosts a State of the City address in each of the five Southside cities. We're delighted to host this Suffolk State of the City again this year in 2015. Today's event showcases Suffolk excellence in local governance, economic development, and issues that impact the business community and the daily lives of the citizens in Suffolk and throughout Hampton Roads. Mayor Johnson, I want to take this opportunity to personally and very publicly thank you for your leadership and thank you for your friendship. Ladies and gentlemen, Linda and I have had numerous conversations over this past year, usually over sushi. But I can tell you unequivocally that Linda Johnson loves Suffolk, she cares for Suffolk, and she puts Suffolk first always in every decision that she makes. So again, Linda, thank you very much for your leadership in this great city. I also want to thank the City Council and the rest of the city officials for all you do. On behalf of the Hampton Roads Chamber and the Suffolk Board, we look forward to continuing to work with you and the rest of the city leadership throughout the years to come. It is now my pleasure to introduce our distinguished guests here at the head table. Off to my far right, Mr. Joe Witt, Senior Executive Vice President of Old Point National Bank and the 2015 Chair of the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce. To his left is Ms. Susan Davis, who you just heard from. She is the 2015 Chair of the Suffolk Division of the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce. To her left is Ms. Selena Cuffey Glenn, the Suffolk City Manager for a few more hours, a day, or something. And I'd like to pause here for a minute, Selena, and let you know that the Chamber and the business community wish you the very best in your future endeavors in Richmond. And we want to thank you very much for your, I believe, 10 years of dedicated service to this outstanding city. You will be missed. Richmond's gain is certainly our loss. And on behalf of the business community, I'd like to present you with a small token, a coin.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for everything. And next to Selena is Mr. Patrick Roberts, the Suffolk Deputy City Manager. And next to my immediate right, Ms. Diana Klink, Director of Media and Community Relations with the City of Suffolk. Obviously, to my immediate left, the Honorable Linda Johnson, who is our keynote speaker. She'll be introduced after lunch. And Ms. Dawn Glenn, a President of Town Bank Suffolk, and our generous presenting sponsor for today's luncheon. Mr. Stephen Blunt, pastor of the First Baptist Mahan Street Church. Welcome, Pastor. And Chief Cedric Scott, the Suffolk Fire and Rescue. Give this head table a round of applause. Thank you. I'd also like to introduce members of the Suffolk City Council who are with us today. As I say your name, please stand or raise your hand, and if we could hold applause till the end of all the city councilmen and women being announced. First, our Vice Mayor, Leroy Bennett, Councilman Mike Duman, Councilman, is it Duman?
Duman.
He's D-Man. He's D-Man. Councilman Roger Fawcett, Councilman Don Goldberg, Councilman Tim Johnson, Councilman Curtis Miltner, Councilman Lou Ward. Give our city councilman a round of applause. We also have with us today, of course, the Suffolk Public School Board, starting with the chairman, Michael DeBransky, the vice chairman, Enoch Copeland, Ms. Linda Burchard, Dr. Judith Brooks Buck, Ms. Phyllis Byram, and Mr. Davis Mitnick. Give the school board a round of applause. I'm sorry, I obviously missed a couple. Ms. Lorraine Skeeter and Dr. Dewan Whitney, superintendent. Thank you. From our constitutional offices, we are delighted to have Sheriff Riley Isaacs, City Treasurer Ron Williams, and the Clerk of the Court, Randy Carter, Commonwealth's Attorney, Phil Ferguson, Commissioner of Revenue, Susan Draper. We also have with us from the General Assembly, Senator John Cosgrove. And so, yes, give them a round of applause. From Senator Kaine's office, Tim Kaine's office, we have Diane Kaufman. And from Senator Mark Warner's office, we have Aaron Carr. From Congressman Randy Forbes' office, we have Curtis Byrd. So give them a round of applause as well. Did Mayor Kenny Wright make it? Kenny, I understood, was en route. Councilman Bill Moody from Portsmouth is here. So give them a round of applause. And of course, from the great city of Virginia Beach, Mayor Will Sessions is here. Mayor Sessions, welcome. I'd also like to recognize the city staff and the public safety officials. Would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you for all you do every day. Ladies and gentlemen, a few more admin things before I turn the podium over to Pastor Blunt for the invocation. We certainly want to recognize our outstanding sponsors of this event today. Our series presenting sponsor is Town Bank. Thank you. Our series platinum sponsor is Bon Secours Virginia Health Systems. The series gold sponsor is Geico. The series silver sponsor is Sentara Optima Health Plans. And the bronze sponsor is the Franklin Johnson Group. Additionally, our table and program sponsors are listed in the back page of your program, so please take a look at them. And we want to thank all of those sponsors for all of their support of the events and all they do in this community. So give the sponsors a round of applause. At this time, I'd like to turn the podium over to Pastor Blunt for the invocation.
Every head bowed and every eye closed. God of our weary years and of our silent tears, Thou who has brought us thus far along the way. Father, we are eternally grateful today for the heritage of your goodness, for the favor, the grace, and the mercy that met us early this morning and has started us on our way. We ask now, dear Lord, that you would allow your presence to lead, guide, and govern us even in this moment, as we are even now grateful for how you have kept our city for another year. We ask now that you would be with our mayor, that you'd be with all of our elected officials, to those who have served previously in elected leadership. We're grateful today for the great staff of this city, the wonderful volunteers of this city, and for all of those who serve to protect our nation. We're also grateful, Father, for the men, the women, and the children who comprise the great tapestry that is Suffolk, Virginia. Having said that now, Lord, lead us and guide us. Allow your presence to govern us in a wondrous and a wonderful way, and allow all that we would do, allow us to continue to give your name the praise and to be thankful of who you are and the great work that you've done by your sovereignty of keeping our city together. It is in Jesus' name that we do pray. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Blunt. Okay, everyone, enjoy your lunch. And again, this year, the menu was selected in accordance with the mission of the Healthy People, Healthy Suffolk Initiative. I'm not sure that includes the dessert bar afterwards, but it doesn't. Okay. All right, bon appetit, everyone. We'll be back with you after lunch. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, can I get your attention, please? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, please continue to enjoy your lunch while we start our program. It is my pleasure to ask Don Glenn, the Chesapeake, Portsmouth, and Suffolk president of Town Bank and our presenting sponsor, to the podium to introduce our keynote speaker.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's a wonderful day to be here in surprising Suffolk, isn't it? Glad to see so many friends and family here in our community today to celebrate Suffolk. I have the distinct honor and pleasure this afternoon to introduce a dear friend. Mayor Linda T. Johnson was elected to Suffolk City Council in 2000. She represented the Sleepy Hoe Borough for two terms and became Suffolk's first female mayor on July 5th, 2006. Mayor Johnson made history once again when she became Suffolk's first directly elected mayor on January 5th, 2009. She was re-elected again for a second term as the directly elected mayor in 2012. Mayor Johnson began her career in real estate in 1986, and she's currently with Berkshire Hathaway Town Realty. She has been a member of the Board of Realtors and the National Association of Realtors since 1986. Mayor Johnson also serves on the City Council's Finance Committee, the City Council's Education Committee, the Hampton Roads Planning District Commission, and is a member of the Virginia Workforce Council. She is also the Vice Chair of the Hampton Roads Transportation Planning Organization, Chair of the Hampton Roads Military and Federal Facilities Alliance, and the Chair of the Hampton Roads Mayors and Chairs Caucus. She was appointed to Governor Terry McAuliffe's Transition Council on Local Government. Mayor Johnson holds a Bachelor of Arts in English and Journalism from West Hampton College at the University of Richmond, with also a minor in sociology. In addition to all of her professional endeavors, Mayor Johnson is active in several community service organizations. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in extending a warm welcome to our friend and Mayor Linda Johnson.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to the city of Suffolk. And as everyone knows about me, I have a script, but I always go off script. So I'm going to start by going off script for just a moment. Two things I want to acknowledge. First of all, you know, everyone knows that politics are local, right? It's all local and it's in your grocery stores. And one thing that people always say to me when they see me in the grocery store is, how do you always have that beautiful smile? I love to smile. And you all are the reason I love to smile. But this afternoon, there's actually two very special people in this room that I would like to recognize, because they are the reason that I smile all of the time. And that is my son and his beautiful wife, Tripp and Mary Johnson. Thank you for being here. The other thing I want to do, we're going to be recognizing a lot of people throughout this, and I promise you we're going to get through this very quickly because I know you all have important things in your lives. But there's a very special person with a very small department that makes all of this come alive, and that is our media and community relations. Diana Klink is beside me. We never recognize her for what she does, but all of what you see today is a result of Diana and her team. Diana, I'd ask that you and your team stand up. They are working the cameras, they're doing it all, they've decorated the tables. I cannot tell you how much they've done. They've helped me with this speech. They've had the red pens, the black pens, the blue pens, and I just thank them so much for all of it. Having said all of that, thank you, Don, for that wonderful intro. You are too a dear friend. And to all of you, good afternoon and welcome to the city of Suffolk. And as you can see, we've rolled out a red carpet for you. The Suffolk State of the City is presented by the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce, and on behalf of everyone, I want to say thank you to the members of the Chamber. Thank you so very much. Practicing the philosophy that no one can achieve success on their own, they know that true success requires cooperation and partnerships, and they strive every day to be that conduit of change in facilitating communication, coordination, and collaboration throughout the entire region. I'm delighted that you could join us for today's State of the City as we prove once again, and yes, it is obviously a movie pun intended, that it is indeed a real, as you have on your table, good time to be in Suffolk. As a prologue to today's presentation, you'll note one common theme is evident throughout. We are one Suffolk, a city with solid shared values. We are strong, and we must continue to build on our strengths. We are proud of our historic roots, our past, and yet we are appreciative of the visions of progress as we continue to direct our own destiny. We know that the plans, investments, and decisions that we make today will define what we look like in the next 25 years. As mayor, my fellow council members and I recognize that every day we are building our tomorrow. I would like to ask that our members of City Council stand and once again be recognized. It has been said that coming together is a beginning, keeping together is progress, and working together is success. We can have all of our legitimate discourse but still come together and make the decisions and investments that are needed today that will pay those dividends for years to come. We acknowledge and understand that we have a stake in strengthening the very places that help define us. We all, businesses and citizens alike, share in this dynamic experience of what Suffolk is becoming, and we share a vision for an even brighter future. I'd like to thank those who help us achieve that vision, starting with what one could consider the storyline's director, our city manager, Selena Cuffey Glenn, and I'd ask that you stand and be recognized. Since becoming our city manager in February of 2008, under her watch, we have literally weathered an F3 tornado, brought about the revitalization of the downtown corridor, achieved the acclaimed AAA financial bond rating, brought in close to $1 billion in capital and business investment, and added over 7,700 jobs to the Suffolk economy, and all during one of the worst recessions in the nation's history. Selena, we thank you for all that you have done, and we wish you Godspeed in Richmond. I'd also ask at this time that Patrick Roberts, our newly appointed interim city manager as of Monday, please stand and be recognized. Patrick, we also thank you for your years of dedicated service, and we are confident that your vast municipal government experience will continue moving this great city forward. Leadership is believing in the future, in yourself and in others, and about building the culture, the courage, and the confidence in those around you to excel. And you both have certainly done that. I would ask that all of your experienced, dedicated department heads and their fellow city employees here with us today stand to be recognized because you have that vital supporting role in our success story. Don't be bashful. Stand up. We're proud. Together with their co-workers that weren't able to join us today, they epitomize the very best traits of public servants. Their professionalism and hard work continue to help us shape this great city into one of the finest, not only in Hampton Roads, but in the state of Virginia. We continue to play a vital role in the national military home front, and I'd like to bring you up to date on the subject and its local impact. The United States military's presence in Suffolk is represented by two major operations, the Joint Staff, J-7, and the U.S. Navy Information Dominance Command. Combined, the operations employ over 3,200 enlisted civilians and contractors, operating in over 600,000 square feet of state-of-the-art research and development facilities. The Joint Staff, J-7, supports the Chairman, Joint Chief of Staff, and the Joint Warfighter by saving lives through joint training, education, doctrine lessons learned, and concepts. The J-7 fulfills other directives through joint efforts with multinational allied command transformations. The J-7 is led in Suffolk by Rear Admiral Kevin Scott, who regrets that he was unable to join us today. But we welcome Captain Christopher Hayes, assigned to the Joint Staff J-7, and ask that you please stand, sir. Chief of Naval Operations, Admiral Jonathan Greenert, directed the commander, U.S. Fleet Forces Command, to establish an information dominance type command, known as TICOM, which officially stood up in Suffolk in October of 2014. The TICOM will support relationships with the best of the Navy, the rest of the Navy, focusing primarily on the Navy's information environment. The Information and Dominance Command is an interdisciplinary corps that possesses a deep understanding of potential adversaries and the battle space. It's able to accurately identify targets and bring an array of non-kinetic, offensive, and defensive capabilities to the fight in the information age. We are so proud to be a stage for the security of this nation. Suffolk is so honored to have you. While we're on the subject of our military, I'd like to take a moment now to ask all of our active duty or retired military guests to stand for that honor you so deserve. We all know that freedom is never free. We salute you for your patriotism, and we extend our sincere and heartfelt thank you for your sacrifices and your service to our country. Suffolk is also home to a different type of military hero, Operation Homefront's Military Child of the Year, representing the United Coast Guard and the nation, Caleb Parsons. And I'd ask that he and his father, Ward Parsons, Petty Officer First Class in the United States Coast Guard, please stand. Caleb, I met you earlier. Caleb attends Kings Fork High School and is a member of the Air Force Junior ROTC. We congratulate him on his accomplishments and wish him well as he is headed to West Point after graduation this year. It's been said that some are destined to succeed and some are determined to succeed. This could be our tagline, as Suffolk is a unique blend of both of these mottos. Employment and housing gains are continuing on the upward trajectory, and we're taking every possible advantage of that trend. We're no longer that sleepy little town, a moniker by which many have associated us in the past. What we are is a city poised for a title role in a shining future. We won't keep you in suspense any longer. Throughout today's presentation, we'll take a look at the segments that make up our success, starting with our financial standing.
Like the start of all movies, financing is the root of every production. So too is it with municipalities. Keeping a city on track to its budget is not an easy task. It is an arduous and demanding process requiring skilled and experienced professionals, countless hours, number crunching, and sometimes hard choices that end up on the cutting room floor. While the movie industry might have its A-list, Suffolk can proudly state that for the first time in its history, it has achieved the highly acclaimed and much lauded AAA rating following an upgrade by Standard & Poor's Rating Services on the city's outstanding general obligation bonds and long-term rating. Not only did the Standard & Poor's rating for the city see an increase, but there were gains with both Fitch and Moody's as well. The AAA rating has been a goal of this administration, which has overseen the city rebound from a drop in credit worthiness and cash on hand in the mid-2000s. In these upgrades, the city was lauded for strong management and financial policies and our consistent ability to maintain balanced budgets as well as our robust economy. Starring in a leading role in the success story is Lenora Reed, Finance Director.
I think it's bright. If management continue to be strong and make prudent financial decisions that are in compliance with the financial policies, maintain strong and sound reserves, record positive operating performances along with having a growing economy, the future of Suffolk finances will be positive. And this mimics some of the comments made by our bond rating agencies.
While a AAA rating is an achievement, the equivalent of an Oscar, we're not resting on our laurels. The city continues to work toward keeping the gold standard in financial measurement, as well as striving for additional upgrades from the other two rating agencies, who also feel we're moving in the right direction. Sharing that same outlook is David Rose, the city's financial advisor with Davenport & Company, who had this to say about some of the key factors that played into Suffolk achieving this auspicious rating.
I think basically it's several. Number one is management. When we talk about management, we're talking about not only staff and people that work here, but also City Council and the leadership that they have shown that basically gave a lot of comfort to the rating agencies that the city was on the right track and doing the right things. The second thing was the finances themselves. The city runs a balanced budget year after year. It maintains a series of financial policies that it complies with and has for a number of years. So again, the fiscal discipline has been there. And then finally, it's a dynamic city in terms of growth. And when you look at those three combinations, it's really a powerful thing, and people want to be here.
Cost savings with borrowing money has allowed Suffolk to make key investments in local infrastructure. The critically needed new City Hall and E911 call center opened its doors in September 2014, and with the demolition of the old municipal building done and the new parking lot being constructed, project completion will take place this summer. Bringing multiple municipal offices under one roof in a one-stop shop layout is not only more efficient and convenient for our citizens and businesses alike, but it's certainly more cost-effective from an operations standpoint as well. The City Hall building is a major feature of the Ring of Opportunity, a zone of targeted downtown development which continues to take shape and of which all citizens can be proud as even more people and economic vibrancy gravitate to this historic area. In cinema, there's always opening credits, noting, based on a true story. Ours is this. The city is in strong financial shape with a prudent eye on expenditures. We feature a lean municipal government with a workforce who is invested in the continued success of this city.
As mayor and as representative for all of the citizens of Suffolk, I believe that our most basic responsibility is to be accountable to taxpayers as to how their dollars are spent. I think most of us would agree that having our financial house in order is the first and most important step to continued economic recovery. With this in mind, our recent budget was about courage and sustainability, the courage to follow recommended responsible funding options to support critical priorities that can be sustained over time. Just as in the film industry, you must have a balance when it comes to the working together of figures, so too is it true in our own budget. The adopted budget sustains our quality of life by addressing the priorities of education, public safety, and the quality of life for our youth and seniors. It also ensures that the health and welfare of our citizens are protected. All of this while complying with the sound and fiscally responsible financial policies that have enabled us to become one of only a handful of Virginia's AAA cities. We will not backslide or lose any of the hard-earned ground that we've gained as we continue on that road to what I call a triple A trifecta, when all three credit rating agencies bestow that pinnacle of financial disciplines upon us. This ambitious achievement will allow us even more investment into those categories that are most important to our citizens. So you see, we've been right on target when it comes to balancing our budget in a disciplined way that is in keeping with our own progressive values. And speaking of Target, just a few short weeks ago, Governor Terry McAuliffe announced that Target Corporation will invest approximately $50 million to expand its distribution operation on Manning Bridge Road, creating hundreds of new jobs. Target has been an active community partner since its facility opened in 2003. In fact, some of you may remember that we actually hosted a State of the City event in their expansive warehouse back then. We don't just see Target as a major employer in Suffolk, but as an ally and a stakeholder in our city's future. Again, their decision was a testament to Suffolk's workforce, its strategic location, and operational advantages. With the Port of Virginia truly a global gateway, the climate here is favorable for companies to invest, reinvest, and prepare for what is destined to be our next growth phase. The 2014 Economic Activity Report, which is proudly making its debut in your gift bags today, delivers that message on cue. Every day, we are building our tomorrow. By working together with our local businesses and our citizens, we have the vision, the imagination, the plans, and the ability to build a bright future for this city and the generations that follow, as you'll see here.
In the iconic film, The Wizard of Oz, we all heard the phrase, "There's no place like home." In Suffolk, scores of people are finding this expression to ring especially true. Here, we offer a multitude of choices and places to call home, all meeting the changing needs and desires of today's market. If your choice is an eclectic downtown loft with nearby businesses, Monument Construction in partnership with Sensei Development have you covered.
I would describe Suffolk as a small town with a big city feel in the downtown area. All of the unique stores and boutiques that are popping up give it the urban, chic environment that people look for in a big city, while still having the friendliness and comfort of a small town.
Many today prefer the conveniences and amenities provided in a luxury apartment setting, and still others prefer a single-family residence. Recently fulfilling the lifelong dream of home ownership with the assistance of Habitat for Humanity was Malika Trainum.
It's always a good thing when you can breathe life into a community. You have houses that are dilapidated or just empty fields sitting there, and when you create an opportunity for someone to habitate a home or become part of a community, strengthen a family, it's always a good thing. And Habitat is a family, so once you start with them, they're there with you for life, so it's an awesome feeling.
You could say Malika is now starring in her own reality series, one in which hard work and perseverance have played a major role. Yes, our housing options are as endless as our opportunities, with our mix of family-friendly neighborhoods, historic homes, country living, and urban environments. Suffolk literally has something for everyone. That's one of the many reasons why Suffolk was chosen as one of the top 100 places to live by CNN Money Magazine. Whether you're in Act 1 of your life, single and on the go, Act 2, with a family wanting to take advantage of all our city has to offer, or Act 3, ready to enjoy a well-deserved retirement but still maintain an active lifestyle, Suffolk provides the perfect composition to create your own blockbuster adaptation. All across Suffolk, our population continues to grow as more and more people discover what we have to offer. For it's not only the roof over your head, but the amenities of a city that truly make you want to call a place home.
And I quote from Laura Ingalls Wilder, "Home is the nicest place there is." And I would most certainly agree. And I can tell you there's no place that I would rather call home than the city of Suffolk. As a realtor, one of my proudest achievements is helping people find that place that they call home. And more people today are choosing our city. Just as the words "on location" have special meaning in the movie industry, that meaning is even more significant when it comes to the location where people choose to live and raise their families. Malika Trainum, and I'd ask that she stand. I believe she's with us today. Malika? Not she's... She found that phrase to be especially true when her dreams were realized and she moved into her newly renovated Habitat for Humanity home in East Suffolk. No matter your taste or budget, when it comes to housing choices, we've got you covered. Our thoughtfully laid out plans include well-located shopping, residential, commercial, and medical facilities to add to the convenience of today's busy families. A spectacular showcase for all of Hampton Roads was the Tidewater Builders Association Homerama 2014, located at the waterfront at Parkside. A beautiful traditional neighborhood development with pristine marsh and deep water views of Bennett's Creek. This event was one for the record books as tens of thousands visited and enjoyed not only the lovely homes, but the also scheduled family-oriented special events and activities. I'm also thrilled to advise that downtown Suffolk's ongoing renaissance continues. As you saw in the video, we'd like to thank Monument Construction and Sensei Development for their $9.5 million project that has literally changed the face of an entire city block along West Washington Street. The largest private reinvestment in downtown Suffolk in the past 15 years, they've transformed seven buildings from the early 1900s into exceptional one-of-a-kind loft apartments and street-level retail and office spaces that will lead the way for continued investment and growth in our historic district. At last year's State of the City event, we advised that Meridian Harborview, a luxury apartment home community, would be opening this past summer. And they're thrilled for me to tell you today that they've been fully leased from the beginning and have a waiting list, further emphasizing the demand for that type of housing in our market. Also in the Harborview corridor, ground was broken last summer for 175-unit independent living, assisted living, and memory care rental apartments operated by Harmony Senior Services, featuring extensive shared amenities including concierge services, fitness center, theater, and more. They're actively taking reservations and looking forward to their grand opening this summer. Representing renewed strength and confidence in the residential property market, the Residence at October, an affordable housing community, opened just last week in the historic Fairgrounds community. Built by Lawson Companies, this site currently features 72 apartments with amenities that rival high-end complexes, along with a clubhouse, fitness center, picnic area. The larger product will eventually have a mix of single-family, townhouse, and triplex homes. The excitement of dirt being turned and hammers echoing is also taking place this spring at a new housing development off Pitchkettle Road, Foxville Meadows, a Herndon Construction project. An important factor in deciding where you call home is the quality of your schools. It was Plato who said, "The direction in which education starts a man will determine his future in life." Join me in the classroom as we look at Suffolk's education.
Movies are full of thoughts, ideas, and themes that sometimes transcend our current world. Star Wars took us to another universe. Harry Potter gave us Hogwarts. And Casablanca remains timeless in its message. So too are our schools dedicated to teaching the next generation big themes, large ideas, and presenting them in ways that children can understand. Succeeding in that vital role is Catherine Williams, Suffolk Public Schools Citywide Teacher of the Year, who shares what this honor means to her.
It's quite an honor, and I know that that's something that people say, but I didn't come into teaching until very late in life. I had already worked 20 years and decided that this was what I wanted to do. So I went through ODU's Career Switcher Program, and I've only been teaching 9 years. So for someone to tell me that I'm doing it well, that means a lot to me.
The influx of families, new construction, and local high technology industries are among the many factors driving the demand for quality schools, including the new Pioneer Elementary School, another major infrastructure addition which opened its doors to students this past fall. Two more schools, an elementary and a middle school, are also in the works to meet our growing needs, in addition to the new Northern Lower School campus planned for Nansman Suffolk Academy. The variety of educational opportunities from both our public and independent schools are producing the leaders of tomorrow, who share with you how their education has impacted their lives and most certainly their destiny.
It has impacted my destiny by preparing me for my future, for anything and everything that can happen.
A quality education is important because without it, I wouldn't have worked as hard, I guess, if I had an easier education rather than a quality one. It pushed me to become a better student.
I feel a quality education is important because if you want to be successful in life, you need a strong background in education and leadership skills.
Especially in the American economy, we are a knowledge-based and service-based economic system. So knowledge is what makes you valuable, and education is really what gives you your foundation to be successful in the world, really.
For me, it wouldn't be the education, it will be the teachers, because they inspired me to be the person I am today and to reach for my dreams.
In Suffolk, our students have learned that destiny is no matter of chance. It is a matter of choice. It is not a thing to be waited for. It is a thing to be achieved.
We are working diligently toward achieving access to quality education for all of Suffolk students. This council and this city recognize that our students are the future directors of our destiny, the ones that will take the shooting script and turn it into the feature. Because of this, it is critical that we get the education of our most valuable and vulnerable right. Our Teacher of the Year, Catherine Williams, knows this extremely well, and I would ask that Ms. Williams please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Teachers are one of the most valuable assets our schools have. Dedicated, talented, and passionate about achieving goals, they strive every year to better their product, and we want to give them what they need to do such. Therefore, Pioneer Elementary School opened its doors to students this past September, new minds ripe and eager to learn. And as Suffolk continues to grow, our passion and commitment to education grows with it. And I want to say to the school board, thank you for all that you do. From all angles, our education system is enjoying success. Former Lakeland High School varsity field hockey coach Tara Worley, now the wellness coach for Suffolk Public Schools, was named the 2014 National High School Coaches Association National Field Hockey Coach of the Year. Tara, would you please stand and be recognized for your tremendous impact during your 15 years as head coach of the Lady Cavaliers? Further emphasizing the importance of a well-rounded education, Nansman River High School was selected as a winner for the American High School Theater Festival. A comprehensive and balanced education system is one that can adapt and change with the times. As technology advances on a minute, hourly, and daily basis, our schools are set up to take these advancements and discover ways to utilize them in the classroom. Our schools are providing our students with innovative ideas to bridge the gap between the digital and the real world. Whether it's learning about Suffolk's waterways aboard a boat from the Chesapeake Bay Foundation, or bringing in BASF chemists to discover how much fun chemistry can be. Really? Our teachers are literally thinking outside the box to bring premium educational opportunities to Suffolk students. Through continued initiatives such as our Suffolk Office on Youth and Suffolk Youth Advisory Council, we're also ensuring that our youth have a voice in their community and the skills needed to become the civic leaders of tomorrow. Our Suffolk Summer Work Success Program for youth isn't about giving someone a job. It's about giving them a future and a sense of pride and accomplishment. We are profoundly committed to empowering our young people to succeed and take on the challenges that come. It's not just our fantastic location, our myriad housing opportunities, or our high-tech schools that we're known for, but we're also redefining that word, quality of life. Just take a look for yourself.
We all have favorite movies, those we watch again and again. Like a great film, Suffolk is creating a lasting legacy so that its citizens can have the quality of life that they deserve. Suffolk is the largest city by landmass in Virginia, but feels the smallest because its citizens recognize the importance of community. We have all the amenities of our neighbors and more, but we're different because here we actually know our neighbors. Nowhere is that spirit and fellowship more apparent than in our celebration of National Night Out, which has now garnered for the third time an impressive First in the Nation award in this community building going away party for crime. Events such as these highlight just how important partnerships within the community are, as noted by Chief of Police Thomas Bennett.
While I am very proud of how hard our police officers work to keep this city safe, it takes more than the police department to keep our city safe. It takes our citizens, our business community, our faith community, our fire department, our Commonwealth Attorney's Office works very hard to keep our city safe, and many other city agencies. We're very proud of what we accomplished in 2014. Part one, criminal offenses dropped in the city of Suffolk 14.2% last year, and that's quite an accomplishment.
Healthcare choices also abound, as our citizens have gained even greater access to advanced medical facilities and top-rated physicians, further expanding options and offering even more convenience. A long-standing Suffolk company, Birdsong Peanuts, also has its eye on health, as they celebrated their centennial in 2014 as they serve customers in the U.S. and abroad. The health and well-being of a community have always been important to George Birdsong, their chief executive officer, who continues to find ways to impact the health and well-being of the city he loves as chairman of the Obese Healthcare Foundation.
Most of you know, but many I suspect do not know, that this foundation was created through the generosity of Mr. Obese, who was the founder of Planet's Peanuts and who left into the state over $100 million to be used for healthcare purposes in that area. We have distributed over $30 million to health organizations within our area, and has resulted in dealing with several hundreds of thousands of people that would not otherwise have had healthcare.
Quality of life here is of premier proportions, due in part to the notable first-class medical care, a library system dedicated to public outreach, and the finest public safety professionals imaginable. Combined, all of these complete the trilogy of excellence for our citizens. We're also home to a multitude of events with a focus on improving the quality of life of our citizens, whether through fundraising for those affected by disease, with events such as the Tour to Cure, who chose Suffolk for the cycling event, which serves as the primary fundraiser for the Area American Diabetes Association, as well as the Western Tidewater Walk to End Alzheimer's, the American Cancer Society's Rock and Relay for Life, and Suffolk Relay for Life Golf Tournament, to name a few. Other community events, including the annual Shrimp Feast and new this year, the Suffolk Wine Festival, bring not only good times, but funding through generous donations from businesses and event sponsors and patrons for numerous local charities and worthy causes. Truly a win-win for everyone involved. It's evident that as Suffolk and our quality of life flourishes, so do our opportunities to improve the infrastructure and development that keep the entire city connected, healthy, and on track to produce seamless transitions between all of life stages.
A world-class locality invests in its communities, and few cities do that better than Suffolk. We offer an exceptional quality of life with a side dish of Southern hospitality. It would be easy to look at the beauty of our natural surroundings and call Suffolk remarkable, but we're so much more than that. We're a remarkable city because of remarkable people. Remarkable people like George Birdsong, Chief Executive Officer and General Counsel of the Birdsong Corporation. George, would you please stand and be recognized? We also heard from George in the video related to his leadership with the Obese Healthcare Foundation. Further evidence of his extensive philanthropy, he was the recipient of the 2015 Lenore Matthew Lifetime Achievement Award during the 40th annual Hampton Roads Volunteer Achievement Awards held last month in Virginia Beach. George, thank you for all you do, not only for local organizations, but on a regional and state level. As he shared, also making an impact on the health and well-being of citizens in our city and the region is the Obese Healthcare Foundation, the Suffolk Partnership for a Healthy Community, and Healthy People, Healthy Suffolk. With those members with us in any of those organizations, please stand and be recognized today. Don't be shy. You are truly making a difference in our city. We're all familiar with the saying, the greatest wealth is health. And in Suffolk, we have an abundance of new and expanding ventures in the medical health sector, offering our residents the most advanced techniques and treatments in healthcare. With many options available, new offerings include primary care, specialties, dentistry, and yes, advanced care for that family pet. Bon Secours Virginia Medical Group announced the opening of Bon Secours Suffolk Medical Associates on Godwin Boulevard, a new practice that offers residents quality primary care in a convenient location. Along with their Harborview campus, also set to expand in the future, and their Good Health Pharmacy, they've continued their focus on providing exceptional, personalized primary care and preventive care. They're also moving forward and finalizing plans for the Bon Secours Cancer Institute, scheduled to break ground this summer. Sentara Bell Harbor continues to expand the footprint and services in their Northern Suffolk location. A new $2.5 million build-out at the campus consists of clinical space and houses physical therapy and an expanded Bell Harbor Breast Center, Sentara Cardiology, and non-invasive cardiac testing. Virginia Oncology Associates has moved their location to the Sentara Obese Hospital campus and partnered with them to provide unparalleled access to the most innovative and advanced therapies and latest technologies in cancer treatment. Also new to that campus earlier this year, the Eastern Virginia Medical School opened the Strelitz Diabetes Center of Western Tidewater. The Obese Healthcare Foundation provided grant support for the center, the first of its kind for EBMS in Western Tidewater. This center concentrates on the detection, prevention, and management of diabetes and its most common complications. The Harborview Health Center is now under development in the heart of the Harborview medical community and will complete its almost $6 million facility, and it will be a welcome addition to the community. It's obvious, no matter where you look, that every day we are building on our health. There is no more important indicator of a city's livability and capacity to attract new economic growth than safety. Great films always feature a hero or a heroine in their script, and we have our share of both. As well, we can proudly state that we are fortunate to have the very best public safety professionals in the region, and I'd ask you to stand up and take your applause. There has never been a better or safer time to live in Suffolk. Crime is down in double-digit figures due in large part to the good working relationships our police department has with our residents. In fact, the overall satisfaction level for the Suffolk Police Department is 94%, according to a 2014 study done by ODU Social Science Research Center. Further evidence of community support for all branches of public safety is the phenomenal corporate cooperation of the community and local businesses that collaborated in our celebration of National Night Out last summer and our resulting national first place award. Suffolk Fire and Rescue is also reaching out in our neighborhoods and bolstering fire prevention awareness with their newly introduced Fire Safety Blitz. Just last summer, Suffolk Fire and Rescue took delivery of 3 new ambulances. In fact, public safety project investments overall totaled $40.5 million in just the past 10 years, a true testament to the value we place upon the safety of our citizens. Another key issue that affects our quality of life across the state of Virginia is transportation. And that rings true for us in Suffolk as well as across this region and this state. And I'd like to say thank you to Mayor Will Sessoms, Mayor Kenny Wright with us today. You know, we work on this regionally, and as Vice Chair of the Hampton Roads Transportation Planning Organization, I know firsthand the issues we face. We will find results. We will build those roads. Locally, we'll see state revenue sharing dollars added to the much-needed Route 58 Holland Road widening project, the Kenyon Road connector, College Drive, and Harborview Boulevard intersection improvements. Let's face it, transportation is an integral part of our daily lives. When it goes well, we don't see it. When it goes wrong, it negatively affects not only our day, but in the business world, it affects the bottom line and definitely curtails our possibilities. We can no longer accept that status quo. We must work together and we must get it right. Our libraries are another vital component to our quality of life. They not only play a powerful role in lifelong learning, there's also an overwhelming amount of research that shows that the most critical time to build brain connection is the first 3 years of life. Our library system is continually evolving and responding to the needs of the community with a multitude of engaging programs and activities for all ages, along with our new extended library hours designed to fit the needs of our citizens. Just a few weeks ago, they were advised that they received the Innovative Outreach Award and the Outstanding Website Award from the Virginia Public Library Directors Association. Further, we are one of only 10 library systems nationwide participating in the Libraries Transforming Communities program, funded by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, which seeks to help libraries create stronger relationships with communities and to become agents of positive community change. It's evident that Suffolk's unique and remarkable quality of life is a testament to the fact that there is no better time to raise a family and no better place to be than Suffolk, especially when you also consider our opportunities to indulge all of your senses when it comes to leisure and culture.
Every film production has endless reels of film dedicated to scenes that were edited out of the final film. So too do we edit our memories to include the highlights of a life well lived. And Suffolk stands tall as a great place to create such memories. The industry uses the term depth of field, and that certainly applies to the varied opportunities for leisure and culture in our city. Our award-winning Parks and Recreation Department plays a major role with an ever-expanding array of recreational opportunities for our citizens to take advantage of the natural beauty that abounds in our city, with even more options to come.
The Sleepy Hole Park ADA Boat Ramp Project gives us the opportunity to increase public access on our beautiful waterways on the Nanjamin River. Currently under construction is a fully accessible parking lot, fishing platform, and canoe and kayak launch. The Suffolk Seaboard Coastline Trail is an upcoming project that clearly indicates our continued commitment to providing healthy activities in our city. This 2.3-mile, multi-use, fully accessible trail will be open to the public this summer.
Earlier this year, we also cut the ribbon on the long-awaited Willieville Recreation Center, and we invite everyone to put on some sneakers and take a tour of the revitalized former Robertson Elementary School, which now serves as a welcome neighborhood anchor and gathering place for all ages. Their state-of-the-art exercise equipment, provided through the generous donation of the OPC Healthcare Foundation, is just one of the many features of this building that will continue to impact the community for generations to come. In addition to over 1,900 acres of inviting and picturesque parks, another source of awe-inspiring splendor is the Great Dismal Swamp, where the silence of unspoiled nature is so real you can feel it.
Well, the Great Dismal Swamp National Wildlife Refuge is important to the Suffolk area. It provides an economic engine for ecotourism to the area. It brings money into the city of Suffolk. But more importantly, it's a valuable asset for the residents of Suffolk. It provides an outdoor haven for folks to come out and enjoy the rural area, the wilderness, do some wildlife observation, and just get away from the, have a better quality of life, you know, a good work-life balance, and get out and relax a little bit.
When you add to the mix the abundance of events and activities promoted by Parks and Recreation and Tourism, the spectacular Suffolk Center for Cultural Arts and the amazing Suffolk Art Gallery, not to mention the many private event organizers and the worthwhile civic groups active throughout our city, there's never a dull moment. In other words, if star-studded productions are your thing, Suffolk puts on some great ones. Peanut Fest continues to be a fall family favorite, with tens of thousands of people enjoying what has previously been dubbed one of America's top 50 festivals. Love Local isn't just a slogan, it's a way of life. Whether enjoying nature's abundance at the farmer's market, getting in some retail therapy, or taking in everything we have to offer, Suffolk and our myriad of special events always promise exciting times. Taste of Suffolk has grown from a modest street fair into a series of downtown blocks featuring culinary delights and tasting tours from area restaurants, combined with live music, vendors, and activities sure to whet everyone's appetite for fun. Yes, in Suffolk, your taste buds certainly get a workout as well, with an ever-expanding list of award-winning and eclectic restaurants setting the scene and starring as the backdrop for amazing meals and memories. When it comes to leisure and culture, our citizens expect and deserve the best opportunities to lead healthier, richer, fuller lives. There are a multitude of ways to enjoy Suffolk's many offerings, whether an easy summer night listening to the music at the TGIF Summer Concert Series, fireworks lighting a nighttime sky over the water, or an evening bundled up under the stars enjoying the holiday parade, Suffolk ensures our calendars are full.
Every month and every season brings a new occasion to celebrate in our beautiful city. Helping to create this landmark film focusing on leisure is our Suffolk Parks and Recreation Department, who takes the leading role here thanks to our natural resources, smart planning, and a vision for the future. The opening of the Willieville Community Center is an example of a great spinoff in taking what is already there and making it better. Starring a caring and knowledgeable staff, this facility boasts the state-of-the-art equipment provided by a healthy grant of $250,000 from the OBC Healthcare Foundation. This site is alive and vibrant with 22,000 square feet of activity space plus outdoor activities. Our citizens in Northern Suffolk have a site similar to the Willieville Community Center and East Suffolk Rec Center on the horizon. The city is moving toward with the transition of the First Lieutenant Richard T. Shea U.S. Army Reserve Center from the military to the city. This will provide for the renovation of the facility and a 12-acre site into a recreation center, which will further increase the reach of parks and recreation throughout our city. The department's goal is to provide healthy choices for all residents to find that right outlet. Their work has been praised on a national level after being named last fall by the National Association of Youth Sports as having one of the top five youth sports programs in the nation for children's 4 and 5, called Lil Sports Program. It instills an early age sportsmanship, active lifestyles, and social skills. With 42 current facilities and 2,000 acres dedicated to the pursuit of leisure, there are an abundance of places to visit for both mental and physical fitness. Sleepy Hole Park has seen recent upgrades, including horseshoes, and working to develop a canoe and kayak launch at that site. And that's only the beginning. $600,000 is set aside to provide a facelift and even more amenities for that park. A jewel along North Main Street, the 67-acre Lake Mead Park, continues to develop into an all-purpose park with a walking trail, dog park, skate sports, first-class tennis courts, and kid zone. The lovely waterfront Bennett's Creek Park is a TGIF venue and is currently undergoing parking lot improvements and a new fishing pier and enhanced boat ramps. If water sports are your thing, downtown's 9-acre Constance Wharf Park and Marina also has a canoe and kayak launch in progress. These are just a few examples of amenities and enhancements currently in place, but the backstory is that there's so much more to come. The grant-funded Suffolk Seaboard Coastline Trail is quickly progressing. Come July, the northeast portion of the trail will be opened for residents to bike, run, or walk. The bigger picture is to have the trail stretch to the oceanfront, Mayor Sessoms. But for now, we can enjoy our 2 miles in Suffolk. While Parks and Recreation has worked wonders with site development and repurposing, the Nansemond River is a natural gift that keeps on giving. It's as if the film titled A River Runs Through It was written just for this stretch of water in Suffolk. History and recreational choices abound on this unique part of our city. Access to the river is key, and there are numerous ways to put your boat in the water, enjoy what is there, with even more to come. If you like the outdoors, the Great Dismal Swamp Wildlife Refuge provides a widescreen production with no 3D glasses needed. In late 2014, the refuge celebrated its 40th anniversary. From the birding festival to the owl prowl, the refuge does not disappoint. Moving from nature's stars to those on the stage, the Suffolk Center for Cultural Arts is home to quality performances and an array of experiences that tantalize the arts taste buds. The Suffolk Art Gallery also has carved a place in local community. There are unique classes offered throughout the gallery, and the Art League calls the site home. Art is truly alive and well in Suffolk. Let's face it, when you go to a movie or a theater performance or just out on the town, food is usually on the outing's menu. Suffolk's distinctive blend of restaurant tastes can bring out the foodie in anyone. In addition to award-winning restaurants through the city, there are other exceptional ways that food is brought together to showcase what we have to offer. The Suffolk Division of Tourism features 2 restaurant weeks, in addition to a new offering, the Culinary Crawl. These events serve to link the hungry with some of the best food in the area with a fun experience on the side. Suffolk's marquee shines bright with existing premier productions and exciting coming attractions, sure to satisfy even the most discerning critic. Watch me now as we hear from our epic Economic Development Director, Kevin Hughes, as we feature our new and expanding businesses.
We see throughout the city of Suffolk opportunities for a wide variety of different type of businesses and industries throughout the entire city, from quality of life enhancements and shopping opportunities to manufacturing, logistics, office environments. The future of Suffolk looks very bright for a number of different type of industries throughout the city. Thank you.
Kevin, would you and your amazing staff please stand so we can recognize you for all that you do? Creating a film is a laborious process from the first gestation of the idea through the shooting script to the completion of the final product. A film masterpiece can take years to complete. Economic development is similar in that vein. New projects and businesses don't just come overnight. They take time to cultivate and get it right. Strategic planning, key location, a highly trained workforce, and business-friendly environment once again catapulted Suffolk to the position of one of the fastest-growing cities in Virginia and a top pick for business development in 2014. New and expanding business investment was an impressive $111+ million, resulting in more than 827,000 square feet developed and over 380 new jobs. These projects didn't just happen working with private and public sectors in a business-friendly environment. This group made it happen. The business community not only strengthens the local tax base, but they also sponsor programs, events, and become true members of our community. We have great corporate citizens, many of you in the room today, and I can't thank you enough for all that you do. People are recognizing Suffolk for what it is, a city that is growing rapidly with major opportunities for expansion. With close proximity to major highways and ports, Suffolk is becoming the place to do business in Hampton Roads. Sharing that philosophy is Freont & Associates, headquartered in Oakland, California. They recently announced an expansion of their furniture manufacturing operation by investing $17.4 million to establish its first Virginia location in CenterPoint Intermodal Center. A factor in their decision to establish an East Coast location was the efficiency of the Port of Virginia. The impending expansion of the Panama Canal that will double the canal's capacity was another aspect in their decision to locate in Suffolk, who also competed with Baltimore for the Freont expansion. Suffolk, S-U-F-F-O-L-K, is how you spell logistics. Bet you didn't know that. The phrase, "we move your world," is more than an economic development byline. With over 10 million square feet of prime warehousing space ready to occupy and an additional 20 million shovel ready, Suffolk has room for you to grow. Add to that our mid-Atlantic coastal location with two-thirds of the U.S. population within a day's drive, our proximity to the Port of Virginia, and our expanding rail and road hubs. Companies here will be in that logistical sweet spot. This past summer, Suffolk was home to the Ballistic Defense Collaboration, where almost two dozen nations and organizations gathered and participated in a group defense discussion, collaboration known as Nimble Titan. The emphasis was on education about missile defense and the importance of deterrence, further evidence of the importance role Suffolk now plays on the international front. In a meeting with Rear Admiral Scott, he shared that the J-7 was recently awarded contracts totaling over $876 million for joint force development training, experimentation, and warfighting solutions until April 2019. That's great news. Reed Integration, specializing in highly technical systems, engineering management solutions, and training, announced they were awarded a five-year, $23.5 million contract to provide schedule cost and risk analysis and estimating support to NASA. This contract expands upon Reed's previous support for NASA. Reed also cracked the top 10 for the Virginia Fantastic 50 listing, a list of Virginia's 50 fastest growing businesses, and achieved Hampton Roads' highest rank. Another North Suffolk company, Ishpi Information Tech, was presented with the Department of Homeland Security's Small Business Achievement Award at the 11th Annual Small Business Awards Ceremony in Washington in early April. They were one of only two companies to receive this prestigious award for their support of the United States Coast Guard. The Kroger Company, the nation's largest traditional supermarket retailer, was a welcome addition in North Suffolk as they opened their new Kroger Marketplace store in the Hampton Roads Crossing Shopping Center last December, just in time for Christmas. Breaking ground in Northern Suffolk is the First Team Automotive Group, who will invest $6.5 million to bring a Subaru dealership to the area. further expanding the list of outstanding automotive options to our community. Suffolk not only welcomes large businesses with open arms, but we also embrace our small businesses that we call Suffolk home. We'd like to extend our congratulations to Corving & Company, LLC, named the Hampton Roads Chamber of Commerce Small Business of the Year for Suffolk. Of course, it wouldn't be a true State of the City address if we didn't have a special announcement, or in this case, announcements. For this category, and today we've got some fantastic news to share with you. We already know that Northern Suffolk's Harborview has established itself as a retail destination. They're no longer just a residential community, as they've transformed into Hampton Roads' newest spinoff destination for administration, banking, medical, modeling and simulation, cybersecurity, and shopping. That's quite a bundle. The Hampton Roads Crossing, anchored by the Kroger Marketplace, is expanding to meet Suffolk's ever-growing market demand, and their master developer, Terry Peterson Companies, who we have with us today, is proud to announce the following new tenants have executed leases. Ross Dress for Less, a department store chain of off-price apparel and home fashion. Michael's Arts and Crafts retail chain. Petco, a retailer that sells small pets, pet services and products. Okay, ladies, here we go. DSW Designer Shoe Warehouse, seller of brand name footwear and accessories for men, women, and children. Ulta Beauty, a beauty store chain featuring cosmetics, skincare, hair products, fragrances, and full-size salon. Five Below, a discount chain geared at teens and preteens that sells products for no more than $5. And Outparcel Spaces will welcome the future tenants Zaxby's, Texas Roadhouse, and Express Oil. The Hampton Roads Crossing has proven to be a strong economic engine and will grow to be an even greater community gathering place. I couldn't be more thrilled and supportive of this dynamic mix of tenants that has selected Suffolk to grow their business and look forward to seeing this retail destination moving forward. In our closing credits, the distinctions our city has earned in recent years is a tribute to the perseverance, planning, and teamwork of an entire community, private citizens and public servants, business and industry, military and civilian, all who value the rewards of hard work and share hopes for an even brighter, more promising future. We all inherit the responsibility to continue that success. Where do we go from here? What will our next chapter be? I am confident that our city will continue to grow ever more capable, exceptional, and vibrant with every passing year. As any good production company knows, even while your film is enjoying success, in the theaters you already begin formulating your sequel. And Suffolk is nothing if not prepared to accelerate its success, to capitalize on its resources, and to move our AAA-rated city towards even greater heights. For Suffolk's history is being written literally by the minute, from its revitalized downtown to its bustling warehouses to new construction. We are the fastest growing and the most dynamic city in Hampton Roads. So join me in helping to write Suffolk's next chapter, wherein we are all the authors of its destiny and whose success will continue to achieve the loftiest of heights. As the song goes, live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten. Thank you.